Howdy, folks. Thanks for having us here, doing this thing here for the good folks at public television. Here's one called Liza off our new record, The Aquatic Hitchhiker.
1, 2, 3.
I climb a mountain, I see the sea. I swim the hot tub, I climb a tree. Just to be wherever it be, I got to get back to you.
Play music that we're hearing and that we enjoy, which is, we're very lucky because we're not pigeonholed in any way. At any given moment, we can play any style. It's all music that we kind of have grown up with and we've, you know, come to like, and it's very much an Americana kind of mix, you know. But I mean, we're lucky because we don't feel like we have to be any certain kind of a band. We can be a lot of different kinds of bands.
High country slamgrass, I think, is the best description of it now. You know, it doesn't have many walls in it. You know, often, you know, a band will be a certain type of band and fit into one category. But we play Cajun, bluegrass, Zydeco, Tex-Mex, you know, and all these sort of things.
You know. Turn on the night, think of your darling, feeling so right. I'll be back by the morning light, I've got to get back to you.
Thing that's going on in Colorado in bluegrass is that people are playing it in bars, and it's really had been a festival thing or a theater thing, and there's just a lot of people and a lot of young musicians doing the rock and roll bluegrass thing and you know, taking those gigs, and it's heating on itself.
Even though, like, electronica sort of feels like it's taken over in a lot of ways to a lot of those fans, there, a lot of those people really are starting to get into bluegrass now.
We used to joke about how, oh, you can't dance to bluegrass. And you didn't dance to bluegrass, really. Bluegrass concerts and bluegrass festivals pretty much were people sitting in chairs listening. And one of the things that we started doing, and we were obviously weren't the first, but one of the things that this band started doing, you know, we added drums and electric instruments, and pretty soon people were getting up dancing to it. And the reason why we started calling it slamgrass is because people slam danced to it, strangely enough, in the early days. And that was a big difference because, you know, at that point you didn't play bluegrass in bars.
About little muscles that attach to the bottom of your boat, and when you're running in between watersheds, they warn you not to pick up aquatic hitchhikers. And I guess that's what we are. We're leftover salmon, and we travel around to different watersheds trying to leave little pieces of ourselves wherever we go. So I guess we're really aquatic hitchhikers ourselves. That's why we named our new album that. And here it is, Aquatic Hitchhiker.
We did a lot of touring around Montana and Idaho through the years, and Oregon and Wyoming, and especially Montana, I think, is where most signs are. And I remember the first time I saw one, it said, "Stop aquatic hitchhiking." And I thought that was the coolest thing. Like, what is that? What is aquatic hitchhiking? I mean, let's do some aquatic hitchhiking. Are there fish on the side of the road hitchhiking? I mean, don't pick up like a, you know, a barracuda or whatever.
Yeah. when you, you know, hear about a band, you go to their Facebook page, you can hear their stuff, you can, you know, that kind of takes some of the mystery away from it, you know, but I think it also helps you to be able to sort through a lot of recorded product that's out there now and find that which appeals to you, you know, that musical texture that you like, or that songwriting that you like, and I think that's a positive thing.
We're a band that started before the internet, which is interesting, and before cell phones. And when all these things started happening, you know, we watched as things started to change. And it basically destroyed the record industry. Not completely, but pretty much blew it apart pretty good. So it's good and bad in the respect that you can get out to a lot of people easily because of the internet, but you don't sell as many records as you do.
Thanks, y'all.
That's a quite a kids actor.